Hi guys and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to adjust the engine valves on your four-stroke scooter the right way. I will show you the easiest way to access the engine valves, which parts need to be removed or can stay in place, how to approach the process correctly to avoid any mistakes, and what tools you will need for the job. Let's get straight into it. First thing to know, you need to adjust the valves when the engine is still cold. So if you are doing this as a part of a service, make sure to do it before changing the oil, because the oil changes are done with the warm engine. Alright, I'll first put a cloth under the scooter to catch any oil drips. To get to the valves, we will need to remove the helmet compartment. On most scooters, there are two screws here, two at the top and one here. Once those are out, you can lift the helmet compartment just straight up and off. The valves are under this cover here. To make things easier, I'm also going to remove this other cover here. Some scooters don't have this cover, and if it's the case, you might just need to take off the whole panel here. This cover is usually held on by four screws, two at the top and two at the bottom, there and there. And some of you might have a secondary air system attached, in which case there are two additional screws here and there. Now we will need to remove all of them. For that you will need a 10mm socket wrench. It's best to loosen the screws in a crisscross pattern to avoid any bending or deformation of the metal. And once all the screws are loosened, you can remove this hose. You can also do this before unscrewing the cover if you prefer. Now carefully pull off the cover and remove it. And here are our two valves, the intake and the exhaust. Before we adjust them, we need to get the piston in the right position. To do that, I'll go to the right side of the scooter, to the fan wheel cover. You don't have to take this cover off, but I'll do it to show you what's underneath. Here on the flywheel you will see some letters, and on the engine casing there is a little notch, don't ask me what it's called. To adjust the valves, the piston has to be at the top dead center. That means that the T on the flywheel needs to line up with the notch. You can turn the flywheel to get it there. By the way, it will be easier to turn the flywheel if you remove the spark plug. But watch out, there are two dead centers, and here's how to tell if you got the right one. First, when the T is lined up here, there is a hole on the camshaft disc and it should point forward. And the second point is when you wiggle the fan wheel slightly, the camshaft should move a bit, but the valve should stay still. And this is how it looks like from above. See, there is no valve moving. And if both are true, you have found the right position. Now let me show you what it looks like when it's wrong. We have still the T lined up here, but the hole on the camshaft isn't visible. And when you wiggle the fan wheel, the valves move too. And again, the look from above. And here you can see that the intake is moving too. And that's not the right position then. So I will turn the flywheel one full rotation and check again. And now it's correct. And here's the trick. On the most scooters, you don't even need to remove the cover. There's usually a nut here that you can turn with, in my case, 13mm socket, and you can reach it through the cover. And you can also see the markings if you just remove that rubber cap. With some light, you can see the notch and the T marking pretty good, So you don't need to take anything off, just pop the rubber cap off and turn the flywheel. And it actually should work for the most scooters. Unfortunately, not all, but the most of them. To measure the valve clearance, you will need a feeler gauge. You can pick up one at any motorcycle shop for under 10 euros. Next, find out the correct clearance for your scooter. Most Chinese scooters use 0.1 millimeter for both intake and exhaust valves, but some have 0.05 millimeters for the intake and 0.1 for exhaust. For my scooter, it's 0.1 millimeter for both. So grab the right blade from the gag and fold the others away. And now slide the blade into this little gap here. It should move back and forth with a slight resistance, but not too tight, but not loosened either. If there is no resistance, like here, the valve needs adjusting. To do that, loosen this nut with a 9 millimeter wrench or socket. Then adjust the clearance using this little knob here. Now insert the 0.1 millimeter blade again and tighten the clearance until you feel the slight drag. If it's too tight, the blade won't move, and if it is too loose, it'll slide around with no resistance. And when it feels right, use pliers to hold the adjustment knob steady and tighten the locking nut, and be careful not to let the knob move while you are tightening. After tightening, check the clearance again. Sometimes the adjustment might shift a little bit when you tighten the nut. Use the 0.1 millimeter blade to check, and then double check it with the next size up. The next size is 0.15 millimeters, and this blade shouldn't fit if the adjustment is right. If the 0.1 millimeter blade fits and the 0.15 millimeter doesn't, you are good to go. Do the same with the exhaust valve. It's a little bit trickier to reach it, but the process is the same. And don't forget to recheck the clearance after tightening the nut. You might need a few tries to adjust it. And when you are done, put the valve cover back on, tighten the screws in a crisscross pattern again. If you have a torque wrench, set it to 10 Newton meters. If not, just tighten them by hand. Don't overdo it. A ratchet in this size should be enough. No need for a big lever. With the valve cover back on, reattach the hose if your scooter has one. Now you can start the engine and let it run for a few minutes. This warms up the valves and the clearance might shrink a little bit. If the scooter runs smoothly, doesn't stall and accelerates well, you have done a good job. And finally, don't forget to put the rubber cap back on. Reinstall the helmet compartment, and if you took off the front panel, put it back too. And that's it. If you have any more questions, drop them in the comments. If you like this video, I'd really appreciate a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more videos and tips. And with that, goodbye and safe travels.